Hi friends, please subscribe to Amravati Media and press the bell icon for more latest updates.
Thank you, madam, for letting me talk on this motion of thanks to the president's address. Madam, to start off, I would like to reiterate that our party is opposed to NRC and even NPR. Our government has issued a GO where they have removed objections by the minority community, and that GO is going to be enforced in our state. So we request the government to reconsider the questionnaire in NPR also, so that there is no insecurity in the minority community. And we had supported CAA. It was perceived to be meant for only three countries, people from three countries, Afghanistan, Pakistan and Bangladesh. But I would like to bring to the notice of the House and the notice of the government that we see people in the streets every day, even in my constituency, in my state. So government has to address this. Government has to see that there is no insecurity in the minority community. I hope the government acts on this, madam. Madam, and coming to our issues, Andhra Pradesh is a new state, it's a new baby, ma'am. We've been requesting for the past 6 years, from when AP Reorganization Act has been passed, we've been requesting that we need support. We were born with unviable finances. So we've been asking for special category status. It was promised on this very floor of the House. We've been asking for implement all the points in the AP Reorganization Act. We request the government to act on this. We see, ma'am, we heard earlier that special category status could not be given because of 14th Finance Commission. We totally oppose this. The 15th Finance Commission in its report clearly stated that there is no link between the 15th Finance Commission and special category status, and it is only an executive decision. So we demand special category status. This is, we have lost count of how many times we have demanded special category status and how many ways we have demanded. So we request the government to act on this, and we also request the government to act on this revenue deficit grant. So it was promised that whatever revenue deficit for the new state is there in the first year, it will be reimbursed. The CAG has pegged that revenue deficit at 22,900 crores, but so far it has not been fulfilled. And we also request the government to release the backward district development fund which was promised to us. It has been pending for more than 2 years. The backward district of Rayalaseema, 4 districts and 3 in Uttarandhra, we are demanding that the funds be released at an earlier date. Madam, the most important project for our state is Polavaram. Polavaram is going at a brisk pace and it is going to be completed in 1 year. But we request the central government to release the funds in time, release it in every 15 days. Because for the past 6 months, 5,000 crores has been pending for our state for the Polavaram project. But till today, the funds have not been released. Only a part amount has been released, and our government, in spite of all the financial stress, we have ended up paying 500 crores only for interest. So we request the government to take note of this, and I also request the Honorable Prime Minister to take note of this. Like, we have seen, like, the earlier Prime Minister, like Jawaharlal Nehruji, who did Srisailam Dam. We want Honorable Prime Minister Narendra Modi ji to take credit for doing Polavaram in time and helping the state of Andhra Pradesh. And madam, in the AP Reorganization Act, Kadapa steel plant was supposed to get support from the central government. Kadapa is a backward area. We don't have enough jobs there. It is a dry area. So we request the government to keep up its word and help in setting up this Kadapa steel plant. And also, a port has been promised. Ramayapatnam port has been promised. Rights has come with their techno-feasibility report where it is viable. So we request the government to come forward. Madam, you can't exclude an area or you can't exclude a state, and you without supporting a state, you can't dream of or you can't aspire to be a 5 trillion economy. And madam, in the recent all-party meeting, my friends from Telugu Desam have raised 2 issues. One is regarding scrapping of projects and one is regarding the capital. So I would like to clear air about this, though it is a state issue, but since they have raised n number of times, they have been talking about this. So I would like the House also to understand what is happening in Andhra Pradesh. Our government is under severe financial stress. The new government, which has been formed under Y.S. Jagan Mohan Reddy, we were inherited with 40,000 crores pending bills and plus 20,000 crores additional bills which are pending in spite of the huge financial stress. So our government decided that we don't want to scrap any project, but we only wanted to renegotiate and re-tender the projects. Madam, I would like to recall Honorable Prime Minister's words when he came to Andhra Pradesh. When he was in Andhra Pradesh, he commented on our former Chief Minister saying that they have turned Polavaram project into an ATM for corruption and there was corruption in the capital. This is proved by the fact that there was reverse tendering in the 5,000 crore project for Polavaram and 800 crore rupees was saved in one single project, madam. Just before election, just before 6 months, 70,000 crore worth of projects were tendered by the former CM. And all the tenders were given at 5% excess rate. That clearly shows that it is a cartel. And now, after re-tendering, we are saving close to 10 to 15% in each and every tender, madam. There's one example I would like to give in Veligonda. There's a tunnel work which happened. The same contractor who had got a work at 5% excess, and the same contractor has bid after a month, when we re-tendered, he has bid for 15% less. So where is this money going, madam? Where did this money go? And why has it not been done before is our question. And even to talk about affordable housing in TIDCO, where the central government sponsors one portion and state government does one portion and the third portion is borne by the beneficiaries. So it was tendered at 2,200. Our state government for 7 lakh units, they have retendered it, and now today we are saving 400 rupees per SFT. That means each household, all the 7 lakh households, are getting a saving of 1 lakh per household. That is substantial for the poor people, madam. This is what our CM is trying to do. He is taking everything in a transparent way. And he, in fact, is the first state in India to put a judicial commission to vet all tenders. Each and every tender is transparent, and any tender above 1 crore has been will go for a reverse auction where there is substantial saving for the government. Madam, I would like to also bring to the notice of the House that in our capital area, there were tenders for temporary buildings. If you go anywhere in India, the construction cost is 1,500 rupees per SFT. But if you see in our capital, Amaravati, temporary buildings with land free and sand free were given at 11,000 rupees per SFT. So, madam, we have to question such scams, we have to question such things because it is public money and we are here to protect the interest of the public. And I'm coming to your point, please. And I would like to, there was one more thing that PPAs have been scrapped. I would like to make it very clear on the floor of the House, no PPAs were scrapped. Only some PPAs, like 41 PPAs, which the former Chief Minister Chandrababu Naidu concluded agreements just before the elections at 4.83 rupees. 41 PPAs were done, ma'am, when the same corresponding time in the neighbouring state, the unit for power was only 3 rupees, and it was below 3 rupees also. So where is 4.83 rupees and where is 3 rupees and below 3 rupees, madam? This we have questioned, and now it is in the purview of judiciary. Whatever decision comes, we are going to respect that. And even now, all the PPAs, we are taking power from them, but we are awaiting the decision of the court, and we will adhere to that. No PPAs have been scrapped. And to add to this, in renewable energy, madam, I would like to bring it to the notice of the House. I am proud to say that under our new Chief Minister, Government of Singapore and Abu Dhabi Investment Authority, they have come forward to put the world's biggest integrated renewable energy project in Andhra Pradesh. It is worth 25,000 crores, and the government of Singapore is happy to invest in that, and very soon our chief minister is going to inaugurate that project. Such is the development and such is the thing our PM is focusing at. So basically, I know, madam, this is a state subject, but since there were allegations made in the all-party meet, we have to make things clear here. And about talking about our capital, madam, I would like to bring it to notice that Amaravati was declared a capital, madam. But before that, as a chief minister, Mr. Chandrababu Naidu said that close to Vijayawada, there is a place called Tiruvuru. He said the capital is going to come up at Tiruvuru officially as a chief minister. And then in 3 months' time, he made his people buy in a place called Amaravati between Guntur and Vijayawada. They bought so much land, and now a preliminary investigation is showing that 4,000 acres plus has been bought by Telugu Desam leaders in that area, madam. Madam, as a CM, if he is fooling the people saying that capital is coming at Tiruvuru and then after buying land and making a big scam, it's a breach of oath, and then he says, no, no, the Tiruvuru is not the capital is going to come up in Amaravati. This is a big scam, and now a preliminary investigation shows that 4,000 plus acres have been identified with Telugu Desam people, and very important fact, the whole house should take cognizance, 780 people below poverty line have spent crores of rupees buying land. How can a person below poverty line put crores of rupees? They don't have even income tax assessment. Now, today I read in the news, madam, it's a welcome move that ED has come into place, CID has reported to ED, 780 people have been identified where there's false certificate and money swindled from the people. They have bought lands there. Madam, we also demand a CBI inquiry from the government so that this camp be bought out. And one thing I would like to come out, ma'am. Earlier, before the election, our former chief minister went throughout the country saying that we will finish off Modiji, we will finish off BJP. But today, madam, earlier he said that we don't mind which party he supports. Earlier he said we'll make Rahul Gandhiji as the Prime Minister. But today, there was a request earlier in the Speaker's office that they don't even want to sit with the Congress, madam. They are sitting behind us. This is the thing. Please, I request the House to take note of Telugu Desam Party. They have been. I don't mind Telugu Desam people shouting behind me, because I'll tell you one thing, madam. They have been assigned with a task to save Chandrababu, save from his camps. This is the reason they'll be shouting. They'll be propagating all lies. We are ready. Whatever facts are there, we are ready to bring it out, madam. We request the blessings from the House for a young chief minister who is performing so well, who is weeding out corruption, and I wish everybody's blessings is there for our CM, madam. Thank you very much.